After the successful design of the five elements yagi, I decided to make a longer yagi for a use at home. And that's this one. It contains 10 elements. The problem was that the boom was made out of packaging material of IKEA product, and it was not stable enough. It was very weak, and when you point it to some direction, it goes flat, it catch wind, and it was not so good. So I decided to change the boom material to some PVC tubing. Also, you can see the dipole element. This is the way I connected the connector to the driven element. Just straightforward, but it is asymmetrical to symmetrical, and I did want to make it a better way this time, a proper way this time. So I changed it into another method. As a feed, I decided to go for the pausy balun, and that is this one. It's very easy. You have your coax cable normally going to the dipole, and now the one side that you connect to the center pin of the coax cable, you now have a parallel cable of a quarter wavelength and connect it here to the shielding. This can be the same rest piece of coax of a quarter wavelength, but you can also make some thick wire or so. This forms an open line and it shortens the common mode. So this is a rather good usable balun for VHF and above. In accordance with Managal, this should be the performance. However, I did not really measure it. I compared this antenna from a balcony and a 70 centimeter band source some 50 meters away, and I compared this antenna with a commercial available one, F9FT, with the same boom length, and I didn't notice any difference. So it looks good. Let's put it on the ceiling. So this is the antenna on the ceiling, made of the slits of a window screen. I taped it with normal plastic tape on the PVC boom with a clamp on a broomstick. And this is the balun. Here I go to the dipole, the driven element, the cable, coax cable, to the connector, and in parallel another wire that forms the balun, the pausy balun. As you can see, it is sometimes pointed directly to the roof or to the wall, and I made many contacts on it with it on 70 centimeter band. And if you are interested in the dimensions of this antenna, I show it now. So enjoy building this kind of antennas, or do at least some kind of experiments with these antennas. And subscribe to my channel, and maybe you find more interesting stuff.